Thank you, Mike, and welcome to Omaha, Georgetown, and Creighton. Inside the CHI Health Center, these two will square off twice in 6 days. Tonight, round one between the Hoyas and the Blue Jays on FS1. With Bill Raftery, Kevin Fitzgerald with you. Glad you're with us this evening. Bill, for Creighton, it's business as usual. This team has won three straight. Marcus Zagorowski might be playing his best basketball of the season. Meanwhile, Georgetown returned to the court on Saturday after 3 weeks without playing a game due to a COVID pause. What do? They take down Providence in inspiring fashion. So now the reinvigorated Hoyas, they got to keep up with the highest scoring team in the league tonight.
Kevin, they got to take good shots so they get balance on the floor, push the ball with opportunity breaks, and pound it to the big fellas inside. And conversely, we know what Creighton does. Push the ball, space the floor, get the puppies organized, and drill those threes.
All right, let's go look at the Jeep starting lineups. That starting five is a familiar one for Creighton. Here's my nugget for you, Bill. That starting unit, all juniors and seniors, they've scored more than 5,000 career points. On the other side, Georgetown going to go with Chudier Bile in the starting lineup once again tonight after his breakout performance against Providence on Saturday. Went for 19 points in a gritty win for Georgetown. The officials, Lamar Simpson, Matt Potter, Kip Kissinger, and away we go. The first of two between these two teams in a matter of 6 days. Bill, it's a light week for Georgetown. Creighton twice, and then they just had the Villanova game added on Sunday.
Ooh, the league isn't doing them any favors, I can assure you. By the way, this is Lab's favorite building. They've dedicated a keg or two in his honor in this building over the course of time. And, of course, Greg, so active in the Coaches versus Cancer.
And you can see the pink lining on the jerseys. The pink mask for Greg McDermott tonight. And yes, this is a very important game, a hot ticket year in and year out, I should say. A game dedicated to cancer research and cancer awareness. So there's a bit of a slowdown here, Bill. We may have an official change just before tip. So Patrick Ewing, in his fourth season at the helm, the Hall of Famer, takes a seat.
When I was coaching, I like to change officials at halftime some games, you know. They wouldn't mind getting rid of me either. I thought Patrick's team really played well the other day. I mean, really sound, good judgments, the big guys involved. Bile, as you mentioned, just had a fantastic game, maybe a breakout, as you noted. Really does some nice things, slips well, drives it, finds, and Big Mac. Everybody gets along with this guy in the league.
He's trying to get the scoop here. Well, you're right,
He's probably trying to get the advantage, if you more like it.
So the typical strategy, right, is if you're the head coach, you want to replace the official at half. Not often before the game does that happen. New official, Pete Larson. And that is our crew. We have started underway in Omaha. Glad you're with us.
And Kevin Fitzgerald right now, the Hoyas come. Littman! Great ball movement, slip. They've loved that hop right there. Well diagnosed.
Well, that was Bile, who you just spotlighted. He causes the chaos in the paint. And Javon Blair scores the first bucket for the Hoyas.
Now, what a great read by Bile. Coudier really stepping up. And they could use it with this stretch run. Loves to come back over that right shoulder.
It was a big one for Georgetown. Went 3 weeks without playing a game. Had the 2 week COVID pause. Only had 3 or 4 days of practice leading up to the game against Providence to get prepared.
Now, this is the end of the floor. They've got to really use good judgment. Don't be in a hurry. Inside out is a nice way to work. Zeleko can't cuff it up like that.
A turnover. That's just what Steve Lavin was saying. They must take care of the basketball like they did. Only turned it over 7 times against Providence. Here's Mitch Ballock, the 18-footer. Well, he is one to only hit net on his threes, but usually it's the swish and not like that.
He was too close. He likes to step behind that line.
He's been launching them from 30 feet these days. His coordinates were all off on that one.
Yeah, the logo almost broke. This kid really knows the game. Terrific passer. Great feel on this. Maybe too unselfish.
This Creighton offense just continues its freight train-like pace. It scores more than 80 points a game. They shoot 49% from the field.
And Harris has to be sound, too. Get everybody involved. Nice cut.
Kudus Wahab.
Yeah, he's got to be more committed on his move.
Creighton back to 15th in the AP poll. It's a new record now. 18 straight weeks ranked inside the AP poll. And that stretches back to last season, the Big East championship year.
Remember, Greg, 244 wins at Creighton. Amazing. Empty side, bro.
Zagorowski almost lost it. Jefferson leans in, and he keeps it alive.
Well, he has been so consistent all year long. Been driving the ball real well, very strong going to the rim as well.
There he is from deep. It's
some range, and boy, can you space and be creative off the bounce with a kid like that.
The air ball from 15, the perfect swish from 30.
Nice lob.
Wahab.
Walked this guy up the lane. Set him up beautifully.
Zagorowski underneath. Yeah, there's finishing with the right hand.
Kev, I love the way he keeps the dribble alive.
A junior from Massachusetts watches as Blair splashes a three.
Is he having a nice year? Isn't he up to 17 points a game? Great rookie year, then sort of not solid years like this year.
Zagorowski drains it.
On a pretty good run the last few games, isn't he?
The Big East Player of the Week, Billy, scored 19 in that comeback win against DePaul. They were the comeback Blue Jays last week. That jumper offline. Belay. Second effort. Flips it to Wahab. And started to shuffle the feet.
Well, that's two already. Christian really holding his ground, creating chaos for the big fella.
And you can
be patient.
Bill, you can see the size difference there. Bishop at 6'7", going up against the 6'11 Wahab.
Now, you can drag Wahab away from the hoop. That's why they get a lot of these ball screens. So he's not even showing. It's going to open up opportunities like this, keep the dribble alive and fine.
Jefferson now 0 of 2 from deep. Georgetown.
They really play with 2 point guards because Blair makes over 4 assists a game.
Oh, it's an offensive foul.
He did that head bob, too, to attract the attention. Years ago, he may have gotten the call. Once you extend the arm, you've got some problems. A little southpaw. Another Canadian kid. Boy, that's so obvious.
Yep. Especially with the official right there, the perfect view.
But you got to get concealment. Ball screen, a little shuffle cut.
It was
that's really great. That's a problem for Wahad. He just doesn't have the mobility to go out. Bishop, small forward or power forward, but a center for this team, and why not? Get him organized out there. Alec, the great touch, the dive to the rim. Bishop pounds it.
East Player of the Week went for 19 and 18 in those two road wins a week ago for Creighton. Boy, he is so smooth. We've seen him, Bill, get off to a nice start. He's already made a couple of field goals. What did Greg McDermott say? This is the closest he has been to what we saw before the meniscus injury last March, playing some excellent ball.
Yeah, he says he's getting back to where he was at one time. You know, he's sort of the ideal. People talk about a combo guard. He's got a nice feel of when to make a play, when to make a play for himself. Just has a real understanding, the knowledge of how to direct a team. Very unassuming. Looks like he's a great teammate as well.
So measured. Always plays with intensity while under control. This is Blair, and he splashes the three. Nice start for Javon Blair, the senior.
He really is a confident player. Has a little floater in the lane, too, if he wants. Terrific range as well.
He already has 8 points.
This team passes the ball beautifully. That's why they shoot it so well. Always hit the guy in the right spot. There's that drop step back. Pretty.
Bishop went with the left hand. He draws the contact of the foul.
Now, Blair, you really got to get up on him, too. There, you got lost a little bit. Mahoney took the long way, didn't tag his guy around that screen, paid for it.
He almost looked surprised to get that much space.
This is another guy with a lot of energy. Plays hard all the time. Occasionally gets some foul problems, Ted, but when he is on top of his game, their offense purrs.
Here's the junior from Missouri, the two-year starter. It's now Ryan Kalkbrenner who checks in. He was big in the win on Saturday. Creighton, it's just business as usual. A little blip a couple of weeks ago. Lost consecutive Big East games. But since then, the win over a ranked UConn team. Three straight W's. Another turnover has the ball back to Creighton.
Nice defense by Balak. Set that up. Great denial on a little box area. This is where you got to stay on your own. The dribble drive turns heads, and here's a nice dive to the rim.
Jefferson.
Oh, he's hurt. Oh, no, I don't like to see this. Just came down wrong. Oh. This kid is one of the tough competitors. Let's see the end of this when he came down.
It's the right foot.
Oh. Let's see if we can see it here. Wad. He must have got under Wad's foot.
The senior Jefferson tended to a timeout in Omaha. A little more than 5 minutes into this one. That is Damian Jefferson, helped to his feet by the athletic trainer Ben McNair. Bill, we saw him come down awkwardly on the right foot just before the timeout.
So often in traffic this happens. You can just see it turn. Oh, my goodness. We've all had them. Some can be devastating. Let's hope that's not true for him.
Yep. That was Wahab. He came down on Wahab's ankle. And, yeah, that is no fun for a player when that happens.
The players are after a great start. 8 points. The rest of the team only two. See if they can get it going.
Dante Harris sticks it.
When he plays well, they're a different team. Not a high percentage shooter, but taking better shots.
The precocious freshman was good on Saturday against Providence. A pass too tall for Mitchell.
A really good scouting by Georgetown early here. Staying at home in the opposite corner. Creighton loves to drive one way, kick the other. You got to really fall down and cover.
It really does feel like a rejuvenated Georgetown team. It's amazing what a win can do. Boy, his first time on the court in 3 weeks after the COVID pause.
Well, they start believing in you.
Delay got blocked. Oh, it went right into the hands of Timothy Igoefe.
Another guy that's been contributing. Gets involved on the glass.
Zagorowski, no.
Yeah.
That's foul on Mahoney.
Yeah, just grab hold. One way you get the rebound. Now just a really nice job here. Being in the right spot, nice look, and pretty good hands at that short quarter release. Not easy to handle that. Great eyes.
So it's Georgetown with a 1-point lead. just underway here in Omaha. These two are going to play twice in 6 days. Pickett for three.
He's got to get going. This guy, I think there's a big upside, and both of us enjoyed Patrick talking about him. Said a lot of the pro scouts, first thing they ask is about him. He's got range, length. He's been driving the ball. He can really turn it up a notch. They could be a different team the rest of the year.
There's Zagorowski. He's been probing the baseline. Kochrunner had it slapped away. Belay starts the run out. A little spin pass to Harris. Although Pickett wasn't anticipating it. The call is last touch by Creighton.
I know Blair got away, but why the spin pass? How about this little dump off? Unfortunate. Well, Harris had the good hands here. They didn't change it.
Now Zagorowski making the case that it hit off of Fego Efe's foot.
I think he was right. Unfortunately, he didn't have the whistle.
Second chance for the Hoyas. 4-8, two Big East wins, the other against St. John's back in December. Two-hand stuff, Fego Efe.
Oh, nice job getting to this right under the ramp. A terrific look. I think it was Blair with the delivery.
Georgetown, 8 of 10 from the field, using its size inside. Alex O'Connell into the game. And draws the foul on the slice to the paint.
Now, all these guys use the ball screen so well. Substitution from the 13, Donald Carey, who's been starting quite a bit, coming on the floor now. Transfer from Siena. Pretty good off the attack. They run a little double screen for him once in a while for a jumper. It always is Jones.
Well, he was looking for Kochbrenner. Another turnover, so a bunch of Creighton giveaways. That's their fourth turnover.
They're very good at getting rid of the ball quickly. If they don't have anything, don't waste any time. Kick it and make a move.
Make it three turnovers. The Hoyas hot on this end. They've hit five of the last six from the field. And they've done it by doing this, going inside, Belay.
That's the game for them. Use those big guys, those big studs to do the damage. The blow by.
Drive, kick, up top to O'Connell. Here's the seven-footer for Creighton. It was all turned around. Four turnovers for Creighton. And the Hoyas have the eight-point lead.
Pretty impressive, Kevin. A great start. Good ball movement. Get them organized, the big fella with the tray from deep. Put it on the deck the next time. You'll own the guy. Good start, Georgetown.
Big East College Basketball on FS1, sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. Jeep, there's only one. It's Georgetown with an early eight-point lead over Creighton, looking for its first win over a ranked opponent this year. A little more than 8 minutes in, and Bill, look at the difference here. Georgetown, 9 of 11 from the field. They're getting it done inside.
Yeah, they're really doing a nice job, sir. Made a couple of deep ones early. So the big guys establishing post position. Good inside passing. And just a solid start. Even defensively, they really reacted, responded to the ball screen dives to the rim.
And Javon Blair, who has it now, leading the way with 8 points, four assists as well.
A little trap first time on the ball screen. This is where I think Creighton's gotten better as a defensive end. It's overshadowed by the prolific scoring. Nice little load up here.
That is a deep post catch. Igoefe couldn't convert it.
Igoefe can make people disappear, can he?
He is the seven-footer from Nigeria.
Big for that ball, big time.
You know, he caught it on the restricted arc. He basically takes up half of the restricted arc.
Big wingspan. They could be really good defensively with them protecting.
He is number 5 in the black, takes a seat. It's Georgetown playing inspired ball after the win against Providence on Saturday. Great backdoor cut.
Nice cut.
O'Connell back up top. Look. Into the corner. Ballock wide open. Bounces in. He got the friendly roll.
Well, he deserves it with that stroke. A little bit of a fumble early. A little deflection. Oh, that's right in the pocket.
Creighton erased that 16-point deficit a week ago in the win against Seton Hall. He was huge in that game. Went for 29.
Well, you just don't stop them from scoring. So many people contribute. Good skip pass over the top. They're knocked down. Once again, DeMarco. Showing his wares.
A little shot-making clinic early on. Now Jones in the same corner they left him.
They can't match baskets with this team. Mitchell really came in and did a nice job. Mitchell really guard a guy, playing with a lot more confidence.
Three in the air for Carey. That one glanced off the window, I think.
Kiss downtown Omaha.
Zagorowski tried to do the same close range. Couldn't get it.
Baha did a nice job altering that shot.
Now Blair, the floater, the foul. He's got two free throws. A senior from Ontario off to a fine start. This is his 106th game, and you're right, Pat Ewing was outlining it to us, some ups and downs, the ebbs and flows of his career. Now he is unequivocally the leader, the top scorer this season for Georgetown.
Really playing with a lot of confidence too. Older guys have been through the mill. They understand a little bit. Look who's back.
Great to see.
It is.
Jefferson came down awkwardly on his right ankle. He rolled it up against Kudus Wahab's foot. And he walked off the floor, but here he is a few minutes later.
If you've played the game, you know you've had ankle injuries, and some are going to be devastating. Some you can live with, and obviously this is a case where good training prevailed.
Blair takes a seat. He has 10.
And Harris will run the show a little more now with Javon hit the pines.
In the corner, Zagorowski spots up. Offensive board to Bishop. Mahoney wants it. Got it.
Well, it's so vulnerable when you get an offensive rebound. How about the soaring of Bishop? Just an unselfish player.
It's still Georgetown by 7. 11 of 14 from the field. What a giveaway. Pickett lost it.
Gotta be tougher. Squeeze that baby. Not a bad lob.
Zagorowski.
He's tough. He toys with you.
Well, he can really just dissect a defense.
Yeah, you don't have to diagram too much when Marcus has the basketball. Just a really good understanding of how to protect it. People cutting, diving, give him an opportunity to set them up where he finishes himself.
And you just brought this up a few moments ago. For Georgetown, you just cannot get into a game where you're trying to match baskets or match threes with an offense like Creighton, no?
Absolutely.
Turnover. Mahoney, left hand, he finishes.
Pretty. That's one thing they've gotten better. Patrick with a quick timeout. Pretty aggressive at the point of attack. Mentioned Mitchell coming on the floor. He can really rank his guy besides being quick to the goal, but glasses and all. Not the least bit foggy with those lamps, with the big time completion with the left hand. Solid.
5-point lead for the reinvigorated Hoyas. Javon Blair, Bill, off to a fine start. He got 10 points.
Well, he's doing it in all areas, whether it's rebounding, assisting, getting out on the break, stepping out, making the threes here. Mahoney gets lost on a good pin down. An opportunity here at the rim, finding people. Just a solid guy. Playing with so much confidence, distributing the basketball. It is a reformation. This is a different team the last two outings.
Raf, if I told you one of these teams was shooting 5 of 5 from deep, you might guess Creighton. Tonight, it's Georgetown.
Amazing. Here goes that game plan. Packing it on D, let him shoot the three.
Pickett has a couple. Blair has the two. It's a turnover. No.
I think it was left there by Mitchell.
Yeah. And Georgetown is bailed out. That would have been its eighth turnover. So that's the first on Sharif Mitchell, the Omaha native, former Burke High star.
Really a solid kid on the defensive end. Gives him a new weapon on that end of the floor.
A great guard off the bench.
And they're giving that to Malik, that particular call.
Blair has to pick up the dribble. B-Lane. Nope. Second chance. Wahab. Fouled.
B-Lane thought he had one there. He couldn't finish with that left hand. Did a nice job on the boards as well. This kid's got a big upside. Really, in a lot of ways, just learning how to play, and who better to teach him than Patrick? He's got a nice little patient way with his right hook.
It's Kudus Wahab, and he is quickly turning into one of the better rim protectors. Not just in the league, you can make the case in the nation as well.
What St. John's game shows is coming out for the league. 17-10, 10 being the boards, and 9 blocks. I mean, goodness. Plus the things he changes on a regular basis as guys get to the rim.
Indeed, Patrick has quite a recruiting advantage going into the home of 7-footers.
I think you feel comfortable. You might learn something about the game. Creighton does a great job just exchanging wings, makes the defense move. An Irwin toss there could have been an open look.
They're just relentless offensively. It's an unselfish roster. Everybody is capable of turning into a selfish player at times and filling it up quickly, including Mahoney. Leads his team in scoring.
Yeah, they spread the wealth, no question about it. And they don't wear gloves. That's a deep one.
There's Wahab with the defense.
I'm going political on you. Nice job. Corner. Just shoving Wahab after that blue dominant area.
Wahab pushes him out this time.
Early drag screen. Nice split.
Splits it. Finds Pickett. Down and out.
And terrific offensive set.
Oh, what a pass. Jefferson. That was Mahoney.
No problem with that ankle. What a sprint and a look.
I mean, bring out the protractor. The perfect angle for that pass. Traditional up and under.
How about that? That's summer camp.
It's Creighton by 7. They make it Georgetown Parton. Fresh off its win against Providence on Saturday. Went 3 weeks without a game due to the COVID pause. And trying to go 2-0 out of the chute.
Just want to play your guy now, lay the shot clock, don't foul.
Jefferson.
How about that? Patience. They can all drill it. Boy, Red Hulls when they look this team. They hit the open man.
Indeed. 4 different Blue Jays have hit a 3. And 5 on each side.
Leave it to Wahab. He's right there. He's off on this particular set.
And they get bailed out by a blocking foul. So they missed Wahab earlier in the set?
Correct. And then Pickett went to the other corner, took away that post up on the other box, and the ball was reversed. It's got to be in sequence.
That's the first foul on Jefferson. That's five team fouls on Creighton. Just three whistled against Georgetown. Harris the inbound. Boy, what a fine start. This is Blair. Nope. Zagorowski, and he realized that was the last one to touch it, so it's going to stay here. A new 20 for Georgetown.
They're really doing a nice job on their offense, though, on a consistent basis, getting really good, clean looks.
Georgetown shooting 63% from the field in the first half. A far cry from what it typically averages. Belay. Pickett tried for the offensive rebound, but Bishop just ripped it away.
Boy, tower of strength on the glass.
There's a foul. It's an offensive foul on Creighton.
He has to move the arms out again. Second time guys have been caught, not particularly. The late got caught the high side. Just a moving pick, I guess. They got Jefferson. Second foul, too.
Yep. Two fouls on Jefferson. The only Blue Jay with multiple personals.
There's the screen.
Blair open again and buries it.
Boy, that is a nice little play. A lot of clubs use that. Big guy screens on it. A high five, he rolls, he gets a back screen by the guard, then a pop out.
Georgetown the aggressor in this first half, 6 of 9 from deep. A few times they've harassed Zagorowski. Extra pass, O'Connell has a terrific closeout, but carry fouled up.
That's what they do so well, they pass it well. On your closeout, you pay mightily if you're not under control. And this is just a pretty play. See Blair with the back screen on Bishop. The pop, no communication. Not on by the southpaw.
Blair with 13. The average is a little more than 17 a night.
And a small change. Ego Effie, Big Timothy. Pretty good rebounding game. 7 of them against Providence.
What a month it's been for the Hoyas. Just imagine the circumstances. Went 3 weeks without a game. And ref, for much of that time, of course, during the COVID pause, your players, it's true isolation.
Yeah, they didn't have workouts, didn't have the whole team together. Let the bounce back with Providence was really a nice pass.
Emphatic stuff. Vicious slam from Bishop.
He knows where to go. Great awareness.
5-point game again. 4 to go in the first half. This is Harris. Rebound to Zagorowski.
Now you close out the half. Very important for Georgetown.
Boy, Harris has done a fine job. And these Georgetown guards have done a nice job containing Zagorowski. Another turnover.
Yeah, why not a little dribble exchange? A big guy looming large. Banging it at home with the two-handed hammer.
Coming up on the Jeep Grand Cherokee Halftime Report, fifth-ranked Houston gets stunned by an unranked team. After beating Virginia, the Hokies let their guard down. Plus, third-ranked Villanova going for a 10th straight win, but getting all they can handle right now. That's all that they have right now. Kevin and Raph, back to you.
St. John's over the third-ranked Wildcats. And a similar story here. How about Georgetown with an advantage over the 15th-ranked Jays? And there's Georgetown at the bottom, Bill, but playing better. No question.
Solid start. Yeah, they really had. The last two games have been very impressive. Much more organized, making better judgments, controlling the ball, not coughing it up in live situations for runouts and open opportunities. Blair has just been as good as it gets for them, too. Making open shots, dribble drive, using the big guys on a regular basis.
Oh, there's a moving screen, illegal screen. That foul is against Igoefe.
Yeah, didn't really get himself. Again, sometimes the cutter or the dribbler are at fault. They don't wait for the screen to be set. Patrick not happy either with the officials or Igoefe.
Up until that turnover, it feels as if Georgetown is the one imposing its will. Ballock. Bishop tried to stuff it back with the right hand, eventually wound up with it, the dive, but it's Pickett. Georgetown accelerating. Pickett wants the three. That's good.
Oh, that's really nice. The Trevor, good organization, a good find, number one. Stricken it.
You go from Bishop with a close range look to transition three. 8-point lead again for the Hoyas.
Zagorowski.
That's a shot he typically hits.
He didn't make him pay for it. That closeout almost cost Georgetown a deuce.
Oh, Pickett back to back threes, puts it in.
Well, the light has gone on, maybe with this talent, the performer. Beautiful stroke. Nice thing about this team, Kevin, they're finding it, too. I mentioned Blair doing a really nice job to trail, trade, nylon by the big fella. And why not stretch it out once more? A little rhythm, bounce, drill it. Big time, Hoyas, tough.
It's Georgetown with a double-digit lead over the 15th-ranked Blue Jays. With Bill Raftery, Kevin Fitzgerald with you. Now it's Pickett starting to feel it. Four triples for the senior from D.C.
And what that does is the big guys, too. Now you've got a wing, or in this sense, he's probably the power forward on this group, able to stretch defense out, easier post-entries. Really unselfish play early by Georgetown.
Well, they're 7 of 12 from inside the arc, 8 of 12 from beyond the arc. Mitchell couldn't get it to go on the baseline. It is a highly efficient day on this side of the floor for Georgetown.
Well, really get the ball side to side nicely, too.
Zagorowski, that's nice. Just a veteran play. Mahoney scores it.
How simple was that, Kevin? I mean, just a nice, easy dump-off pass. Nothing flashy.
The preseason player of the year playing his best basketball the last week or so. He missed those two games due to the leg injury, but since then, oh, he's been money. Now
he's back. He's back, I think. Now that's your candy now. You just get into that low box area. Big fella.
Foul on Carey, his second. Stops the clock, 1:41 to go. I like this play.
I do it in the old-fashioned, really good defense to swipe. And look at the organization here. A lot of kids will do a fancy play that ends up empty. Just solid. Distribution. A second foul on Carey as well, by the way.
You know, there's so many point guards in this league that just embody that steady, unflappable style of play. It's Zagorowski, it's Colin Gillespie.
Mm-hmm. Just getting it done, basically. Posh Alexander, another kid that comes to mind, talking about St. John's earlier. Boy, you wouldn't want him guarding you.
Bishop with 7. 3 of 4 from the strike now. Georgetown has been ahead for almost the entirety of this first half. Just a few minutes ago, led by 11. Carey, the step back three.
Sort of a wasted trip, a settle.
Ballock, this is in range.
How can you leave it? Ball screen, slip, replace on the wing. Alec, number 24. You got to get up in his shorts.
High high level of play in this first half for both of these teams. Blair, wow, that was a nearly impossible angle, and he almost got it to drop.
Very difficult. Seems like they're 2-1 here.
Plenty of time between shot and game clock. Now, Mitchell, boy, he would have had a clean look at the rim. Bishop, yeah, beats Wahab.
How about that going right, too? I think he jumped by that left hand, a little blow by.
So all of a sudden, an 8-0 Creighton run, a huge run just before the half. Does Georgetown have one more bucket?
Boy, Creighton doesn't take the foot off the gas. Did not relax at all.
Gary, skipping into the paint.
Yes.
And just before the buzzer. What a half for Georgetown. They shoot 57% from the field and lead it by 5.
And no bad shots, Kevin. Value the basketball, use the big guy. And Javon Blair making them feel real comfortable with the little dribble drive. A solid end of the half. What more do you want, right? Kerry, coach, for the money.
A fun first half indeed. Blair and Pickett combined for 25. These two teams hit 14 threes. It's a 5-point advantage for Georgetown in Omaha to the studio after this timeout. Fan, you requested that song. Georgetown by 5. Oh boy, 8 of 13 from deep, hot shooting in that first half.
More like John Denver aforementioned, but just making shots, no question about it. And I just think Javon has been terrific. Blair, think of this, Kevin. 10 assists against Syracuse, 6 against Providence. He's already got 6 tonight. That's 22, and still stroking the ball. And alongside his sidekick, Jamarco Pickett, picking up his game, and they're finding him at key times when he's free.
These are the two seniors who have been with Patrick Ewing throughout the 4 years of his tenure as head coach at Georgetown and stepping up in a big game. So we have some spring cleaning in Omaha. You got to go find some backup shot clocks. There are 2 new ones being installed on the court, right on the baseline, which makes me believe the ones above the rim might be malfunctioning.
Absolutely. And usually with Creighton, you don't need a shot clock anyhow. Generally speaking, they get it up and down. First good looking one. They do not have a conscience.
You might have a few players going, well, what is that thing? I've never seen that.
Spare parts.
Well, this should be a good second half. The first half, high level of play from both of these teams. It was this duo, as you mentioned. Blair got going in a hurry early in the first half.
Yeah, just ran a nice pin down for him. Nice little curl. Step back here. Nice pass. Harris finds him and gets those babies organized. Skip pass. Payne. Creighton back for how often they do it to opponents. But the early offense, Pickett just stepping that jump shot and not welcome defensively.
So now it looks like some of these players are getting some extra shots up. So the shot clock installation has caused a bit of a delay. It's just the natural progression, natural maturation, isn't it, for Javon Blair?
It sure is. I think he just fits with this team, though. You know, he got some inside game. He's the kind of a kid that can put it on the deck and get by people. Unselfish too. Early on in his career, he hunted shots, I thought. He was more thinking about himself, but now just stepping in. Has to do a lot for this team.
Well, remember the Daytona 500 right around the corner. The 2021 NASCAR season starts in just 2 weeks. That's it, February 14th. And the Great American Race, the Daytona 500, gets it started, as it always does, only on Fox. So there you go, top right corner, the shot clocks malfunctioning on top of the hoop, the one behind it still working, and then we've got the extras on the baseline. Wahab.
Nice rake. Malik with nice hands, helping out on the big.
Well, we already have another malfunction. I think the shot clock reset, and that might not have anything to do with the actual shot clocks. Someone might have been anticipating the change in possession, which didn't happen.
Dotronix is getting a little free pub here.
And we get to do simple math here. 25 seconds off the clock. That means, yes, 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
Got to attack.
Nice play.
Yep. I don't think he hit the rim anyway, so shot clock violation. Yeah, that possession was destined for a shot clock violation, no question.
That was an unattractive opportunity, but Christian Bishop is just so active.
Number 13 in white, playing with no fouls, always plays aggressive. He's got it.
Little side scissor. Boston Celtic with Russell at the foul line. Can I show my age a little bit?
Well, Cousy didn't have a three-point line to work with. Jefferson did there and missed it. Well, now the key is, can Georgetown keep up with this potent offense?
Now the point totals, if they get the type of shots they had the first half, the answer is yes. Once again, Bishop comes over, changes the trajectory.
He had a pile up on the other end. The first two looks for Georgetown, not the best.
Bishop doesn't take bad shots.
Mahoney misfires. In rhythm shot for Mahoney, who finished with 7 points in the first half. That's about half of his season average. And Bishop whistled for his first foul.
I was wondering whether they're going to get Wahad involved, but that's pretty good play on that baseline denial by Bishop. Got down the floor a little bit late, but still.
Look for Wahab a couple times. You've been begging Georgetown to go to Wahab. Number 34 in the black, Blair. Harris, he's open. Can't stick the leaner. Yeah, strong rebound down to Jefferson. That's his second.
Not a bad shot at all. Wahab had his guy pinned.
Crate has won three in a row.
A little double screen. One goes to the goal, and Ballack, I thought he was going to nail that one.
Well, the layup is off the window and down.
I'm surprised he doesn't do that more often. Obviously, he's a great deep shooter, but the closeouts, you've got to hug this kid with his range. A little blow by the southpaw.
The veteran, the senior from Eudora, Kansas. Blair left it short, and Georgetown 0-3 from the field to start the second half. Ballack went diving, and that's Harris clutching his left hand.
He does a lot of nice things, though. Great effort. I think it's their ball on the possession arrow, but Greg likes it. Even though it's his left hand, he likes that hustle. Doing it all, whether it's the three, the triple drive, or leaving it all, hanging out there with the pink. Hush puppies.
Big East basketball on FS1 is sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. Jeep, there's only one. 3-point lead for Georgetown early in the second half. The Hoyas looking for their first win over a ranked opponent this year. We have seen this script before from Craig McDermott's Blue Jays, at least recently. They're turning into the comeback Jays. Look at the point differential the last three games in their wins against UConn, Seton Hall, and DePaul. They have had to overcome oftentimes some large deficits.
Well, they have some heavy artillery. A lot of guys beat you in a lot of spots. Just a simple screen there. And the roll goodness. They get more of those because they have such great shooters, touches, and then equally as important, the ability to tip their misses. Nice soft caress.
Blair splash.
Talk about artillery fire. Blair, 4 of 5 from deep.
Once again, keeps that dribble alive.
Bishop. Rahab blocked it, and then he realizes that was out of bounds. I just batted it back to Crate.
Well, he's got some wingspan, though. Just really learning on the job. This kid's got a big-time upside. He's mobile.
Just a sophomore.
Yeah, instinctive in his reactions. So's he. What a mid-game he possesses. Pull-up jumpers, floaters, and he can still bite you deep.
9 points for Mahoney. It's been fun to track his evolution. Started at Southeast Missouri State. Sixth man of the year in the conference last year. Now a legitimate scorer and starter. Belay.
Mentioned Mahoney over 1,500 points in his career between the two schools. Too wide, but dodge one on that. Tipping a pick and involved a little bit. Nice little swipe by Balak again.
Blair, quick trigger. Bounces out. Zagorowski on the move. And Harris bumps him. Well, Zagorowski, we're waiting for him to hit one from deep.
Why not, huh? Just a little simple screen. Get caught in it, and you pay the price. And Blair just on fire. Drilling big-time shots, keeping the Hoyas ahead.
Oops. Here's our bracketologist, Mike DeCourcy. He has a number of teams counted up. Got 9 in the tournament. Bill, you just saw Ohio State on Saturday. I mean, who is really dangerous? Who might be the most dangerous in this conference?
Well, they're all dangerous, and I agree. You know, this is a loaded league, no question about it. Saw Illinois last night with Indiana winning over the Sumo, and of course Kofi Coburn. I mean, they just are. Every team is so talented. You don't play your A game, you're going to lose in that conference. Nobody easy. Nobody talks about Penn State. They fight everybody. Mm. It's incredible.
Just ask Wisconsin.
Yeah, Reavers, we had in there in the photo. Can pick and pop. Good low post game.
Mahoney. Oh, just finding his stroke. Now with 12.
So many spots this kid.
Well, and just no drop-off either. You know, if that NCAA tournament was played last year, the Big Ten, I think you could say we're no question going to get 9 teams in. Maybe even 10.
Step back. Tough shot. First one I would disagree with, but clean it up. Baylor.
That's back-to-back buckets for the redshirt senior from Denver. His family and his parents from Sudan. Spent some time growing up in Denver.
Through that side for Zagorowski. Just this terrific footwork. Locks that pivot foot. A little bit like Colin Gillespie in that lane. Very clever. Manufacturing post-ups. Just a little brush, overload one side. There's really not too much you can do. Lahad sort of caught no man's land. Should he stay on his guy or help on Zagorowski?
Well, and are Zagorowski and Gillespie going to suffer similar fates this evening? It's Creighton down here in Omaha. The third-ranked Wildcats trailing St. John's by 10 late in that game tonight. Ranked teams in the Big East are not safe this evening.
No nights off either in this conference. St. John's is really rounding into form. So the aggressive nature, nonstop, challenge everything.
This would be the Johnny's 5th straight win, and no question it's biggest. Off-court feed, Harris has the feet set. Mahoney tipped it to Zagorowski. Now he's on the run. Into the paint. The body control. Jefferson, I think he just pulled the hand back. And Zagorowski has got the basket.
Well, he's got great confidence in the open floor. Knows how to get an angle, how to deliver the punch. Use that body in a body search situation.
Is it a double figures with 10 for a 10th straight game? Belay. Try to go one-on-one with Ballack. Fading back. And it's Iga Efe.
The two guys challenge the shot. Efe cleans it up.
Creighton hasn't led in more than 20 minutes of game time. Wide pass. It got tipped out to Zagorowski. Mahoney wide open. Rolls out. Harris has it.
Well, they really use the floor, don't they, Creighton?
Harris draws the foul, heading to the line.
Zagorowski thought he had all ball. Nice little challenge in the open floor. Just love this kid's attitude. Always under control, little dipsy-do finish. Clever. Great feel for the game.
He's just been surrounded by greatness, if you will, his whole life. It's the basketball family. All three of his siblings played. Max, Macy, of course, Michael. His brother plays for the Magic, the old Syracuse star.
I knew you'd get that one in. The Cuse. Love watching him play.
2 years at the, in the words of our peer, Sean McDonough, the Harvard of Central New York, before being drafted by the Sixers.
I remember them lamenting him leaving early, too, to go to the NBA.
Just signed a two-year deal. Yep, just signed a two-year deal with Orlando a couple months back.
You got free passes to Disney, right? A little more than that, baby.
Call the agent to work that one into the deal, right?
What's in the right hand there? Bishop? He's a tough guard, particularly for a big guy. Always keeps them active.
It feels like you could say that about everyone in the starting unit for Creighton. Here he is. Oh, he got it rejected. Iga Efe just wiped it away.
He goes room running, too, trying to hold the ball.
Bickett's three offline. Georgetown maintaining the five-point edge. Jefferson, no, right at the rim.
Bishop with a nice word off of the lane. Steve Montre.
Wild sequence. And Blair, he can protest, but I think they got it right. He walked.
So many kids are clever in that open floor. He can't believe it. So let's see.
One, two, three.
Oh, yeah. I think he got more. Give him a token on the subway.
A little indecision there.
They've been solid in shot selection, though. I think there's maybe three now. He's had two of them. Two runners he got trouble with.
Georgetown.
Nice play.
A 5-5 Bishop. Maintains the poise in the baseline, and Iga Efe was just whistled for his third foul.
I think number four, if I'm not mistaken. He got one earlier.
Pardon me, that's right. That is his fourth. So the seven-footer to the bench.
These big guys are uncomfortable chasing Bishop around. Always involved in screening. Understands the angles, the slip. He has a lot of nuisance screens, too. Not a bad shot there. That's a nuisance for Georgetown.
Antoine Jones. Creighton hasn't led since the 15-minute mark of the first half. They were down by 11 at one point in the first half. They tied it once since then. The Hoyas maintaining their lead.
Stuck on one side here.
Pickett just had to flail with the right arm. Harris. Anticipation. Into the corner. Pickett hesitated. Drives and slams. Oh,
offensive foul.
What a heads-up play. What do you want, coach? I don't need the ball to help my team. I step out. He's outside the lane, I guess. But just heads-up play on the defensive end. So many things he does to help this team win.
In a lot of ways, tonight's game, the most popular every year out in Omaha for Creighton Blue Jays fans. It is the 11th annual Pink Out game. Of course, a game dedicated to cancer awareness, fundraising effort for cancer research. This game over the last 11 years has generated more than $300,000 for cancer research and awareness. And the fans in the building participating as well. And this game, Raf, it means so much to Greg McDermott. His wife, Teresa, beat breast cancer about a decade and a half ago.
Yeah, it hits home for Greg, and he's been active, as we noted earlier in the broadcast, contributing his time and efforts to beat this dreaded disease and help others. Just amazing what the coaches do. You know, all the cities, too. And you know, we mentioned Syracuse, where you're from. Jimmy's done a miraculous job raising money. A lot more to these guys than just the X's and O's.
And our good friend Rob Anderson, the SID at Creighton, he says this is basically the top ticket every year for Creighton fans. They want to be in the building for this one. You see the pink socks, the pink trim on the jerseys. Mahoney's got the green light tonight. That's what he has. It stays here. He is starting to heat up. He's got 12 points.
Now, that was close to going over that backboard, too. A little difficult angle.
Do you think
of Rob Anderson? I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead, Rob.
I was just going to say, speaking of Rob Anderson, his notes are more than the books I read at LaSalle. God bless him. He can keep you up at night with all the stats and figures. And many of the SIDs, well, all of them, do such a great job making our job a little easier. Jones gets one.
It is a Creighton encyclopedia.
It is. Get the big guy to the box.
Delay after the 19-point game Saturday, having a cold shooting evening. It's a foul on Georgetown.
Just got to relax a little, Kevin. Hodge setting up shop. All of a sudden, you're jacking one up. Give him a touch. He's a willing passer.
Georgetown just 31% from the field this half. It shot 57% in the first. Mitchell. Short. Rebound to Belay.
And here, nice job off a ball screen, faking the pass to the big guy. It freezes the D. Gave a nice open look to Mitchell.
Mitchell all over Blair. Cuts him off in the corner. Carry. Delaney jarred away from Bishop. With the right hand, scores it on the other side.
Well, they can go. They got 5-4 left to go.
Tegarowski. Oh, that great cross-up. Missed it.
That's unbelievable, huh? Everything but so good with the bounce.
Whistle at the top.
Mitchell with the reach in. A little side saddle, gets an open look, and Bele just really active here. Keeps that ball. Really terrific job using the rim as well.
The graduate transfer from Northwestern State. He led the, not the Blue Demons, just the Demons, Northwestern State Demons in scoring last year. And he has earned his minutes.
He sure has. Patrick was telling me earlier in the year where they really looked at him on tape. They never got a chance to see him, right, with all the pandemic and everything else. He said, I thought he was a little bigger. Well, he played big the other day against Providence.
Harris got fouled. And Bishop, frustrated by the call, it's just his second personal.
I don't blame him. That was all ball, I thought. He's telling the refs to look up at the big board. Very active. He's the cornerstone inside.
Oh.
Goodness, that was just a clean play. And the angle of the call was on the far right there.
Well, you can hear what the fans in the building think of that. And Harris has a chance to extend Georgetown's lead to three possessions. And this has, it's just been a consistent Hoyas attack and lead. Creighton last led 5 minutes into the game when it was 13-10. It's been the Hoyas ahead since.
They're playing with confidence. They're tough on this end.
Ballock, the leaner. That one rolls through.
How about that? I thought Bishop may have interfered a little bit. There he is. A little help now.
You've been asking him to get it to the big man, Wahab. No!
A walk, I think.
They get Harris for the foul.
Oh, I thought that was a walk first. Well, just in a hurry on that last attempt. A little small change. Everybody's played solid for Georgetown. Harris included, didn't take bad shots. Got the ball to the right spots.
Now it's Pickett back in.
I'm sorry, Kevin.
No, he had the 12 points. It happened. Nothing since now back in with 9 to go.
The ball's been being stuck on one side. Got to get it onto the other. You ever get to the second and third side, now you've got the defense moving a little bit.
Yeah, has Creighton done something a little better defensively this half as well?
They've made it hard, but I think it's Georgetown. So, just inflicting problems like here. Let's see if we can get to the other side. That's one way of doing it.
There it is. Pickett.
He can elevate now. Plumb Bob. Drop step.
Yes.
There you go. Create your own post up, big fella.
14 points for Pickett. His first basket since the break. And it's an offensive foul on Creighton.
Look at Zagorowski right up there. So important to the team. On both ends of the floor.
Nice move, huh?
Yeah, really nice. Like an NBA kind of set him up. That drop step score. Look at the size, too. Bishop Blumen large at that rim. That's a kiss delivery.
Well, Pat said that to you. He has certainly drawn the interest consistently of scouts for the next level. Wahab. Strong move. Scores it over the left shoulder.
Let him know. Let him in the game.
Not the night to be a ranked team. About 800 ranked teams have lost today. Is Creighton the next? A giveaway. Belay. Bishop tried to foul him, and Belay slams it home. 10-point lead for the Hoyas.
Well, they are really doing a nice job. Quick timeout necessary right now by Greg McDermott. Oof. All of a sudden, the light has gone on with the Hoyas. Good Providence game. Give some touches to number 34. Can finish it here. A little defense to offense. The big fella. Delayed for the moment.
Millions of kids nationwide are without their normal access to sports and play due to COVID-19. That's why Fox Sports and Good Sports are restoring play for kids and the programs that serve them through donations and brand new sports equipment. So get involved. Text PLAY to the number on your screen to help keep kids in the game.
Well, these folks must know somebody to get these tickets because that place is packed. Every night in Omaha, local Creighton Club.
And this game in particular is one you wish the typical crowd could be in the building. The pink out game, although Creighton finds itself down double digits with 7.5 to go.
And this is where Georgetown, you want to get some stops right now.
Mahoney off balance jumper, and that's through.
Nice little play by Bishop, too. Good decision. Now they conversely, they want to dig down a little bit. Bang that floor like Rojo used to do with Duke.
Blue Jays need stops.
Nice job by Ballack. They don't come up with it. Boy, he is an intelligent player.
He forces a late in the shot clock heave. Three free throws are coming for Blair.
Well, you see it so often where guys just don't go out, skip out, jump stop out, or the blow by. And just a reaction. Yes, he got that left hand, a little ticky on the elbow. This kid's not afraid of shots, I know that. Zagorowski's third foul as well.
Blair is really playing at an all-league level for Patrick Ewing this year.
We're getting old, everybody talks about in the country. We've been under the gun, pressure situations.
Harris, boy, he's played well at times this evening.
Within himself, don't you think?
The freshman was great in the win on Saturday against Providence. Blair, two out of three, 18 points. That's just above his season average. A 10-point lead for Georgetown. They haven't won here in 6 years.
A nice little set play.
Ballock, way off. And the shot clock should have reset. I think that's what they're going to stop play for.
Right, they did get the rim.
So it'll still remain Creighton basketball. And, yep, they take one tick off the new 20. Creighton has shot 49% from the field. The problem has been turnovers. 14 giveaways today, well over their season average. And Mahoney is bumped.
They got Pickett with a little touch foul, but that's what Mahoney does. You run out, trying to protect against that three. Track the bounce, mid-range game.
One and one the rest of the way for both of these teams.
Watch your feet, watch your feet.
Mahoney with 15. Back to an 8-point game.
This is where Harris has to run the show now. Little full court, 2-2-1. Try and speed you up a little bit.
Oh, you go get it!
Wahab, one power dribble and the bucket.
How about Belay? I mean, you just courage to get in the lane and find the big.
And he forces the steal and the foul. And Jefferson compounds the mistake. It's a 1-1 for the senior.
Boy, they are so sharp, Georgetown. Immersed in this game, both ends of the floor. Third foul on Jefferson.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, I guess in a way with that sprained ankle, they're lucky to have him out there.
Yeah, Georgetown has a 10-point lead. It has, in every facet of the game, earned that lead. Now, they are playing like a team that is 11 points better than Creighton tonight, no question.
Coutier Belay. He's a shot at that ankle. He's from a different dimension, really. Really good at driving the ball, not afraid to take shots.
This match is Georgetown's largest lead of the evening. Bishop, the long strides, draws the foul.
Well, that's where he can excel, particularly against Wahad or Ego Effie if he's on the floor.
Balance scoring for the Hoyas this evening. Blair leads the way with 18. Pickett, Belay, Wahab, all in double figures. Is that not how the win against Providence looked? It was just a team effort, and everyone had fingerprints on that game on Saturday.
No, I would agree. Everybody was solid. Contributions, heady play. But rounding it to form, really. We mentioned the COVID problems. By the way, Pickett, that's four.
He and Igoefe both have four fouls. Meanwhile, for Creighton, this is a script that this fan base has seen recently. Their last two wins in comeback fashion. Harris twisting. Bishop went straight up, and it's Blue Jays basketball.
Well, it just split it, a little bit of a zone look, that trick. Trying to make an adjustment at the rim. Playing a little bit too deep with the bigs. He's lost control. Bishop always in the right spot.
Ballock, lob, Bishop, one dribble, scores it off the window.
And how about that? Usually goes to the nice bounce to get himself organized. Use the rim.
Mark it down. 11-point lead for Georgetown. Right around the 5.5 minute mark. Does Creighton have a rally in it?
Here's a scramble, almost a 1-3-1 look.
Pick it, no. Jefferson, and here come the Jays.
Get your defense organized.
Zagorowski, the blow by. The dish, reverse jam. Bishop with the style.
All set up by a sellout by Harris, trying to deflect the ball from behind, open up that dribble drive at the rim. Always diving to complement the little dribble drive. How about a little reverse to put a little shoe on by the big fella? Pretty basketball. Creighton on a little bit of a roll. Guard's got to take over for Georgetown.
That is swagger. Oh, the reverse jam in a tight game in crunch time. And so there you go. It's a quick 5-0 run for the Blue Jays. Back to a 2-possession game. And so it's a mirror image almost from what we showed you from the Georgetown side. Four different Blue Jays in double figures.
They're so explosive, Creighton. They just can't key on one guy. And just the excellent footwork and understanding of his position by Bishop. It just creates opportunities that you can't diagram. And defensively, you can't prepare for it. You over-gamble or extend. And the creativity of these kids is just incredible. This is a die attitude either.
Really is. And this team, it just embodies maturity, unselfishness. Now, this team, of course, won the Big East regular season title a year ago. You wonder what could have been if the NCAA tournament would have been played. Just about everybody back. They have been in this position before, especially in recent games. So a potential comeback, nothing new or out of the cards for the Blue Jays.
They just have an air of confidence. They know they can score. Big thing for them is how they guard people. And right now, the guards have to take over. What are you gonna run? Big decisions. Don't let them rush you into anything. There's that little zone look, like a 1-3-1 look. Morphs into a 2-3.
Belay open in the middle. Now 15 points for the senior.
By the way, Pickett only has three, by the way. They changed the foul.
That's huge. A miss, and now it's Wahab with the rebound.
And Wahab was the reason there was a miss. Big time presentation by the big guy. Got a touch inside somehow. With the dribble drive with the big guy.
3:50 to go. Georgetown with an 8-point lead. Wahab backing in. Bishop trying to stand his ground. And Jefferson rises for the rebound.
Once again, a little bit of a hurry. Maybe one more bounce. Nobody was raking on him.
Ballock, step back three. Strong, rebound to Harris. Creighton in the second half, just 2 of 9 from deep.
Georgetown doing a nice job using clock and still getting decent looks.
Oh, the hop. Had a right hand again. That falls through.
Well, they know the answer.
Mahoney baseline drive, fouled by Wahab. The big man has the Hoyas ahead by 10. This should be their first win over a ranked opponent this year. They got 3:02 to go to close it out.
Up on the postgame show, upset Wednesday, both third-ranked Villanova and fifth-ranked Houston get stunned by unranked teams, plus several other top 25 teams go down tonight. It could be five if the Hoyas can hold on down the stretch. Kevin and Raph, back to you. See you after the game.
It is not an evening. You want to be a ranked team. A 10-point lead for Georgetown. Remember, last year, this Georgetown team, they defeated Creighton a year ago. Look at the rest of the ranked teams in action. So four, Raph, have already gone down. Creighton would be the fifth if Georgetown closes this one out. They defeated this team a year ago when Creighton was ranked inside the top 25. Omer Yurt 7 had a strong evening. The Hoyas took down a 25th-ranked Blue Jays team in Washington, D.C. They're on the verge, though, of handing Creighton its fifth loss of the season on the road in Omaha.
It's incredible. Now, the whole evening, Patrick told both of us, defense is better. We're challenging shots. I'm just impressed with their ability to distribute at the other end, getting touches, getting step-in jump shots, getting the guys some opportunities down on the block. Wahab in particular.
12 points for Wahab. That's not a free throw. You can't afford to miss many of those.
Now, when you're trying to get back in, extend the floor a little bit because of the make. A little face guarding, not like the free safety. This is where you need composure.
Dante Harris, the freshman, has done a fine job tonight. Blair, the score. Oh, step back, left it short. 9-point game, Ballock. They need it. Yes.
How about that? They got going right at the rim, and Ballock getting organized and drilling it. Nice acknowledgement with the pass.
Not so fast. Two possession game, 2:20 to go. Delay might have gotten away with it.
Wow.
Georgetown went 3 weeks without playing a game. Beat Providence Saturday, trying to take down its first ranked opponent this year. 3-2.
You think a little bit on your shots.
And we got a shot clock violation. Now, so we're inside of 2 minutes. And did that one catch the rim?
It looked like it
definitely hit.
Yeah. But did the horn go off before? That's, well, tough to tell. We don't have that shot clock above.
Oh, the players were on it immediately, saying,
"Yeah,
that hit the rim." Watch the right side. I think it glances off the right side.
It looked like it hit the glass and then that side.
Yep.
Would you agree?
Yep. Yeah, no question. It hits the window. Yeah, and you could see it change direction right there.
And it was before it expired as well, the release.
Again, Georgetown right here, yep. Belay gets possession. seconds. So they're arguing that it shouldn't be a shot clock violation. We should have a new 20.
20.
Yep. How critical, by the way, this happens at the 154 mark. If this happened 10 seconds earlier.
It's a tough deal, really. But it would really extend time-wise the game. If they started doing the whole second half, would you agree?
Yeah, you're right. So 154 to go. Greg McDermott gets the explanation. And
to his chagrin, I might ask.
That's the way to say it.
The big thing for Georgetown now is who's going to make the play or take the shot. These are the kind of situations now that it's cracker time.
Craig is just clawing back multiple times in the second half. They've got it back within six. It was tied earlier in the half. They have not led since the opening minutes.
I didn't mind Pickett getting that little post up off the bounce.
Harris going to shoot. Someone's got a hoist. Blair.
Now they didn't even pay attention.
Back to the monitor. Did he get it off?
That's unbelievable.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
I think he did.
And...
oh, no, it's still in the hand. Yeah, I did. I think it's a violation, don't you?
Somewhere Eric Devendorf just stood on a table. But it counts. They will keep it.
Oh, they did, huh?
A 9-point lead. Wow. Ballock can't answer. Jefferson fighting to keep it alive. Wow, that is a humongous play late in this one. And now the foul with 1:10 to go.
Yeah, got to stretch the game out.
Javon Blair's three, just a fraction before the shot clock expired, has Georgetown up three possessions. Pickett can extend that. The Hoyas 70 seconds away from maybe walking out of here with a big win.
And this is an attitude adjustment when if they happen to win. All of a sudden, you start teaching from a positive vein.
Creighton needs buckets and in a hurry. Zagorowski, whoa. That almost went down. It was almost a 4-point play. Instead, free throws.
Why? Don't have to. Just be there. Get a hand up. Disconcert. Get three, stop the clock. Nothing good happens.
57.7. If Zagorowski hits them all, they'll have a chance to set up a little press as well. He is 82% from the stripe, best on the team.
You love your point guard who can knock him down at this point in the game.
So they basically get the three back from the Blair triple. Two possession game. Mitchell comes in for defense.
Well, he can really rag a guy. They'll switch now. They're going to harass the inbound passer. For a perfect trap. They got a foul?
Yep. That's on Zagorowski.
All he had to do is get over to that sideline and turn it. An ideal situation.
Zagorowski, that's his fourth. He rarely shows any visible emotion like that. Displeased with that whistle.
He's just placid, calm.
Blair, second in the Big East, as an 86% free throw shooter. Now 4 of 6 from the stripe today. This is a big one to get it back to a three possession lead with 55.2 left.
Well, Georgetown's got to really be solid on the defensive end. Make Creighton use some clock. No gambles, no sellouts.
Each team with a timeout.
Mahoney, head fake, drive, throws it up. Jefferson had it into Pickett's hands. Whistle. It's a foul. Let's go back to a couple plays ago. Javon Blair beating the shot clock. Or did he?
Well, it was awfully close.
Now it's Pickett, 71% from the stripe. Big one. Oh, look at the basketball and the shot clock.
See, I thought it was in his hand still. How about you?
Yep. Well, you said that when we looked at it at that 136 mark. They ruled it a three. And that, huge at this juncture in the game. Instead of a two-possession game, it's a three-possession game. Georgetown less than 40 seconds away. Hand up in Jefferson's face. Offline. Mahoney to Zagorowski. And Harris fouls him again. So two free throws for Zagorowski. I'm not sure he's going to get the three. Yeah. He'll get two.
Why not? Why not big? Trying to hustle, but boy, judgment's got to prevail. Only with a really a heck of a save.
That's twice. Harris has been whistled for a foul inside the last minute. Don't make it any closer than it needs to be. Wahab is back in. What a second half he's had. Georgetown has pounded the paint. Down and out. Wahab, he's heading to the line. The Builders squeezing every ounce of drama out of this one. But the Hoyas,
stretching it out.
They're making Patrick Ewing use that towel that he's got slung over his right shoulder.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, it's over the neck now.
Of course, that's paying homage to his mentor and dear friend, Coach John Thompson. What a career he had, God bless him.
Patrick Ewing's Hoyas, what a week it's been. A week ago, they were just starting to hit the practice court again after the two-week quarantine. They beat Providence on Saturday after a missed free throw. This is Jefferson. Well, the three ball just has not been there for Creighton in this second half in particular. Just 3 of 13 from deep after halftime.
Well, it's been a great scouting report game for them. Took away a lot of opportunities. Got back. Challenged the shooters. I mean, just really impressive by Georgetown. They've grown up.
And take a look, because Creighton is going to see this Georgetown team next Tuesday. They meet again 6 days from now. Marquette sandwiched in between the meetings on Saturday. What has most stood out this evening as to why Georgetown may walk out of here with a win?
I just think the shot selection was impressive. And the turnovers that they did have, they seemed to be in the right spot. Some dead ball opportunities where they did get back, but just solid balance of the floor, challenge shooters. They picked their spots, too. Wahad a couple of times, stepped up and still picked early. Javon Blair was just terrific all game long.
That Mahoney triple is good. 7-point game again. The last timeout for McDermott.
Yeah, the ideal now is to get a 5-second violation. Everybody front, big on the ball. See if you can get that or a quick trap. And obviously the giveaway.
Need the turnover now. The man who led the way tonight, Javon Blair, 22 and counting. 5 triples, a lot of excellent plays.
Well, what do they say in life? It's tough to get old, but in college basketball, it's pretty good. They've been around the block and make great decisions. Pickett used the floor quite a bit. But he did get stuck earlier on one side of the floor. They started to move a little bit, play with a lot of confidence. Harris, great control. Blair in the backcourt, great control.
Ten triples for Georgetown. So they go blow for blow with Creighton.
Right, teams can say that.
Yep. You know, the 22 points, but then the 7 assists as well. He was a facilitator when he needed to be one. Georgetown, they made some contested looks in the first half. They built that lead in the first. They went ahead at the 15-minute mark of the first half and have not relinquished the lead since.
Good job inbounding the pass, too. Harris, he shot the ball after the push. Trying to get a three-shot opportunity. That wants everybody off the line. A lot of coaches do this. The late, great John Chaney was one of the first that I can remember wanted everybody off the line so nobody would go over the top.
I mentioned Big John, just the Titans we've lost over the last 6 months. You know, Pat was explaining such a great story. He said, I remember John Chaney. I was with the Knicks. It was one of my later years. And Chaney was at the game. Jeff Van Gundy invited him. He was watching one of his former players, Rick Brunson. He came to the locker room, talked to us. I was blown away. His presence, what he stood for, what he said to us.
Mm-hmm. Amazing man.
That's an amazing night. If you're a Hoyas fan, this will be back-to-back wins for Georgetown, although another foul. That will be addressed.
He wants to get this one over with.
I think some of the late fouls with Georgetown ahead will be addressed this week.
Well, they beat an excellent basketball team, too, on their home court. And this will shock a few people in the country.
Phil, next Greg, up. Oh, pardon me, go ahead.
No, just to say, I know Greg McDermott will get him back up. I mean, that's what goes on in heavyweight conferences. You off your game a little bit. Somebody steps in, puts you on the mat.
Nice little tune-up, huh, for Villanova. That's who's next for Georgetown. The game just added to the schedule today. Georgetown walks into the CHI Health Center and topples a ranked opponent. Its first win against a ranked foe this year. Blair led the way with 22. You said it. Impressive win for Bill Raftery, our great crew. I'm Kevin Fitzgerald saying so long from Omaha. Let's send it to the LA studio with Mike and Steve.
Wow. Yeah. Hey, well.